students, last video we will discuss point of contact and tangent of a circle and one theorem, 10.1 theorem we discuss. In this video, I'm going to explain exercise number 10.1. So coming to first question, how many tangents can a circle have? How many tangents a circle have?
Infinite.
This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, this is 7. So many tangents can exist. Why? Because a point on a circle exists only one tangent. A circle means combination of so many points. So many points means every point there exists only one point. So many points is there means so many tangents exist. For example, here exists. And here exists. If you take any point, for example, I'm taking a point, there exists a tangent. If you take one tangent, another tangent, another tangent. So many points is there, so many tangents is there. So final answer is infinite tangents in a circle. Understand? So there can be infinitely tangents in a circle. You have to write infinite tangents. Understand? Coming to second one, filling the blanks. A tangent to a circle intersects it in dash points. Okay? A tangent to a circle intersects in how many points? So tangent always intersects at exactly one point. One point. Okay? Aim level. Tangent of a circle, circle degree, A point degree intersect out. Only one point degree intersect out. Coming to second one, a line intersecting a circle in two points is called, a line intersecting the circle in two points is called what? Secant line. What is that? Secant line. Third one, a circle can have dash parallel tangents at most. A circle can have two parallel tangents at most, ends of the diameter. So how many? Two parallel tangents at most. Ends of the diameter. Okay? Two tangents. Coming to fourth one. The common point of a tangent to a circle and the circle is called. The common point to a tangent to a circle and the circle. This common point is called point of contact. What is that? Point of contact. Understand first and second problem? Here a circle, infinite tangents can exist. A tangent to a circle intersected exactly only one point. The line intersecting two points is called, the line is a secant line. A circle can have a two parallel tangents at most. Means ends of the diameter, two parallel tangents. The circle is there. Means the circle is there, two parallel tangents at most. Understand? Coming to fourth one, the common point of a tangent to a circle and the circle is called as a point of contact. This point is called as a, means common point of a line to circle. That is called a point of contact. Coming to third one, a tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of a radius 5 cm meets a line through the center O at a point Q. So that OQ is equal to 12 centimeters, length PQ is how much? So first, the tangent PQ at a point P of a circle. Tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of a radius. Radius how much? 5 centimeters. This is O. This PQ is the tangent. P is the point on the circle, is already mentioned. A tangent PQ, P of a circle of a radius 5 centimeters meets a line through the center O at a point Q. Such that or so that OQ is 12 centimeters. We have to find out this PQ. PQ how much? Understand the question? PQ is a tangent. P is the point on a circle of a radius 5 centimeters. So the distance from center O to Q is given by 12 centimeters. We have to find out this PQ. Theorem 10.1, already we discussed that this OP is always perpendicular to the tangent PQ. Yes or no? The tangent of the line at a point of a circle is perpendicular to radius through the point of a contact. Theorem 10.1 we discussed. Means OP is always perpendicular to this particular tangent PQ. So OP is perpendicular to PQ. Means it makes 90 degrees. Yes or no? So here OPQ is a right angle triangle. Triangle OPQ is a right angle triangle. By Pythagoras theorem, what is the Pythagoras theorem statement? The square of the hypotenuse in a right angle triangle is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides of a triangle. So your hypotenuse is OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square. OQ square means 12 square. OP square means 5 square. We have to find out PQ square. PQ we have to find out. PQ distance we don't know. So PQ square. 12 square means 144. 5 square means 25. Plus PQ square. So 144 minus 25 is equal to PQ square. So how much we get? PQ square is equal to 111. PQ is equal to root 111. Understand? So using 10.1, this OP is perpendicular to PQ. Means the tangent to a point of a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So it makes 90 degrees. So OPQ is a right angle triangle. We know two sides. So by using Pythagoras theorem, here we have to find out the other side of this right angle triangle. Understand? Yes. Coming to fourth one. Draw a circle and two lines parallel to a given line such that one is tangent and the other is the secant to a circle. First of all, draw a circle. Two lines parallel to a given line such that one is tangent and other one is a secant. So one is tangent, another one is a secant. Here it is the center. These two are parallel to line. See once again. Draw a circle. Two lines parallel to given line. For example, this is the given line. The two lines are parallel to this given line. If one is the tangent to a circle, another one is the secant of the circle. Understand? So given line is this one, the two parallel lines are here, on that two parallel lines one become a tangent to a circle, another one become a secant to the circle. Okay? How to represent like, this is N, this is M, this is L. How to write? N is a given line, L, M are two parallel lines to given line. L and M are the two parallel lines to given line. Here L is secant and M is tangent. Just for identification, you have to write this. Otherwise, the diagram is enough. Why? Because you are asking only draw a circle and the two lines
parallel to a given line, one become a tangent and another one become a secant of a circle. Understand third and fourth problem? So here the option is D, root 119. Root 119. Understand? So next video we will discuss some introduction about exercise 10.2.